can you solve this geometry challenge? Here's the question. Let's begin with a triangle having a side length of 7 and 8 units respectively. Now from here, let's call this angle be equal to 2 alpha. And from this vertex, let's draw a segment like this. And let's call this angle be equal to alpha. And this segment right over here, the measure of this is 4 units. Now this is x. Now the question is, what is the length of this segment? X. So pause this video right now and see if you can answer this question, because I will show you the answer and the solution in 3, 2, 1. Alright, the answer to this question, the length of the segment X simply equal to 5 units. And of course the question, how do we get the answer of 5 units? And here's the solution. Alright, to answer this question, what we're going to do is to name some important points in this figure. So this point, let's call this as A, this point, let's call this as B, this is C, this is D, and look for similar triangles. That's one method to answer this question. But looking on this figure, we don't have any similar triangle. And if we don't have any similar triangle, what we're going to do is to create a similar triangle. So we need to force this figure to have a similar triangle. And to do that, we will need this point D. So let's create point E on BC such that this angle right over here is also equal to alpha. Now let's focus on this triangle first. This triangle, we have two base angles equal to alpha. Therefore, this triangle BED simply an isosceles triangle. Now let's call this DE be equal to Y. Therefore, BE is also Y. And in this case, this is not anymore 8 units, because now EC simply equal to 8 minus Y. And now let's focus on this angle DEC. We will use what we call the exterior angle theorem, because take note, the length of this exterior angle is equal to the sum of two remote interior angles. So this angle right over here, we can say that this is alpha plus alpha, or simply equal to 2 alpha. Now let's focus on this triangle right over here. We have 2 alpha. Now let's call this angle CB equal to beta. Now this triangle DEC have an angle 2 alpha and beta. Now the big triangle ABC, we also have 2 alpha right over here, and we also have beta right over here. Therefore, using AA similarity, we can say that the triangle DEC is similar to triangle BAC. So now we have a similar triangles. And using the concept of the similar triangle, we can now find the value of the segment X. So first, we can say that the ratio of segment DC to BC simply equal to the ratio of the segment DE over BA. Now substitute its side length. We have 4 over 8 equals Y over 7. Now we cannot solve for the value of Y. But first, let's simplify this 4 over 8. This is just 1 over 2. Now multiply both sides by 7. We have Y equals 7 over 2. So we now know the length of the segment Y. In short, we can replace all of this Y with 7 over 2, like this. And also, 8 minus 7 over 2, this is just 16 minus 7 over 2, or simply equal to 9 over 2. And now from here, we can now solve the length of the segment X. Because again, using that we have two similar triangles, we can say that EC over AC equals DC over BC. Now here's its side length. We have 9 over 2 over X plus 4 equals 4 over 8. Again, simplify 4 over 8. This is just 1 over 2. Now let's focus on this result. To eliminate the denominator, let's multiply both sides by X plus 4 like this. And again, to eliminate the denominator, let's multiply this equation by 2. And there you have it. Subtract 4 on both sides, we get that x equals 5, which is our answer to this question. Therefore, given this figure, then the length of this segment x simply equal to 5 units. And of course, before we end this video, let's have an extra challenge. So we have this figure, same figure, and your goal is to find the length of the segment y. And of course, if you learn something new in this video, please support our YouTube channel by subscribing, liking, and sharing our videos. And as always, we are done.